The family of Paul Whelan continues to fight for his return home. He is still detained in Russian prison. His family has visited Washington, D.C., where they're now pushing lawmakers to step in and help with the situation. RJ Walker has more from Paul's sister. She joins us from Baseline Road and Luland Drive in Novi.
Paul Whelan would love nothing more than to return to the quiet streets of Novi, the place he had called home before being detained in a Russian prison. His sister Elizabeth says it was a situation that should have never happened.
What had he originally gone over there for? I mean, according to the Russians, he's been over there as a spy, but what, you know, was he originally there for?
He was over there because of an American friend, another former Marine, was getting married to somebody in Moscow, asked Paul if he would do the huge favor of not just coming to the wedding, but also helping out with the guests.
But once Paul was in Russia, Elizabeth says things took a terrible turn for her brother.
Our understanding is that someone he had met on a previous trip and he considered to be a friend, popped in to the hotel where Paul was staying, handed him a USB drive that supposedly contained pictures from a previous visit of Paul's, and then the FSB, which are the Russian security services, the modern version of the KGB, basically burst in and arrested Paul for receiving state secrets.
Since then, it's been a battle to set him free and return him back to the United States.
It's grueling, in a word. This is my 24th visit down, and you try to keep an optimistic attitude. You try to work with people on both sides of the aisle in Congress to make sure that they understand what's going on. Congress has passed, I think, 5 resolutions for Paul now, or at least introduced 5, and definitely 4 of them have passed. Resolutions calling for Russia to release him and basically showing their support.
Elizabeth says keeping Paul Whelan's name on the minds of Americans is an important part in securing his freedom.
And so I have found it necessary to sort of run around D.C. visiting all of these people and trying to keep the pressure on, and also to get those in-person briefings. You know, people don't like to give you classified or even semi-classified information over the phone or Zoom. And so if you really want to know what's going on, you have to come down here. But that is a terrible burden on families to continue to make these trips. The State Department does not pay for them.
So for the next several days, Elizabeth Whelan will be very vocal and very present in Washington, D.C. on behalf of her brother.
I do have meetings scheduled with, for example, a number of people from the Michigan delegation.
Elizabeth says as of now, Paul is still relatively healthy, although Russian prisons are known for being brutal. She says money collected through Paul's GoFundMe page has been used to help keep him that way.
That money has allowed the embassy to send him fresh fruit and vegetables, vitamins, you know, food that allows him to stay reasonably healthy.
So until he's able to come home, his family, friends, and many strangers are still fighting for a safe and healthy return of Paul Whelan. And of course, we'll keep you up to date with any developing details in this ongoing story. Reporting in Novi, I'm AJ Walker, CBS News Detroit.
Thanks, AJ. The U.S. State Department tells us that Paul Whelan has shown tremendous courage and that the U.S. government continues to call on Russia to immediately release both Whelan and Wall Street Journal reporter Evan Gershkovich.